In the last 15 years, West Virginia is 93-6 at home in non-conference games. In game number 100, Long Beach State joined the 93 previous victims or the 6 previous victors. The 2-1 Mountaineers figure to be in for a challenge against the 2-1 49ers this evening at the Coliseum in Morgantown. Hello and thanks for joining us on AT&T Sportsnet for West Virginia basketball alongside WVU Hall of Famer Warren Baker. I'm Rob King. Since that loss in Germany to a ranked Texas A&M team, the Mountaineers have reeled off 2 lopsided wins, including a 62-pointer over Morgan State in which Daxter Miles scored a career-high 32 points.
Boy, Dax was really good the other night. The thing about the Mountaineers now that they want is consistency out of him. If they get that, they'll be one of the best backcourts in the country.
Miles with 32 points on 12 of 15 shooting was 3-for-6 from beyond the three-point line. Now, Long Beach State from the Big West Conference could be a formidable foe. Their lone loss came Saturday night in a close game at Oregon State. Their leading scorer, Barry Ogilvie, scored 17 points in that game, while Gonzaga transfer Brian Albert scored 19. Two of the top teams from their respective conferences will collide tonight. Long Beach State from the Big West and West Virginia from the Big 12 will tip it off in Morgantown next on AT&T Sportsnet. Welcome back to the Coliseum in Morgantown. West Virginia getting set for today's game between the Mountaineers and the 49ers. Long Beach State's starting lineup looks like this. It will go with a 3-guard approach. Levin and Riggins up front. Albert's the Gonzaga transfer. Ogilvie and Booker at the guard position. Dan Monson, you might remember him from Gonzaga or Minnesota. Now Long Beach State is 11th season there. And we will get to West Virginia in a moment as well. We can tell you that Zags Kanate, the center, will be jumping center. Here's West Harris Kanate, with Miles and Carter in the backcourt for West Virginia, of course, coached by legendary coach Bob Huggins in his 36th season, 11th at his alma mater. And we are underway. Kanate wins the tap. Carter takes the ball and man-to-man defense for the Long Beach State 49ers.
Well, Long Beach State starting in a man, but they will play multiple defenses this evening.
Miles, a long three-pointer, no good. Rebound to Alberts. Nothing thought about it.
West Virginia in there, familiar pressure man-to-man.
Lob inside, and Levin gets position and the layup.
Good lob pass over Kanate to Levin. Easy layup. Nice execution by Long Beach.
Levin might be another guy to keep an eye on. He's had big games at against Power 5 conference teams. We get our first personal foul.
Follows whistled on number
block
0,
and call.
His first.
Let's get the
his
tips first to win here, Warren.
Yeah, they have to have good floor balance, and they need to be organized as they're changing those defenses, and as always with against the Mountaineers, you have to box out. Talk about that good floor balance. We saw Morgan State get caught inside a lot. West Virginia got a lot of easy breaks, so I don't expect that from Long Beach State.
West with a three-pointer. Long Beach State looked to be in the zone defense that time. As you mentioned, they will switch up their defenses.
Lamont West looked awfully comfortable on that last shot.
Levin will try for 3. And his 3 is good, so Levin has scored 5 quick points.
A switch there. West Virginia did not communicate. Levin ended up by himself for that 3.
Preseason all Big West Conference selection, Gabe Levin.
I see a little 2-3 zone again. Long Beach State will try to keep West Virginia off balance by switching defenses.
West will try another 3-pointer. This one well short. Rebound to Harris, however, able to bang it out of bounds and will remain West Virginia basketball as we look at their keys to the game.
Well, Barry Ogilvie likes to drive to the basket, and he goes hard. West Virginia needs to create some speed bumps, slow him down some. They do a good job of that. West Virginia also really will have to make sure that they don't understand it's not going to be as easy as it was the other night, and play very physical but smart against Riggins inside.
We saw Brian Alberts doing a fine job there getting the block and the shot clock violation.
West Virginia in the trap.
A lot of good ball handlers. Talking to Ron Everhart before the game, said that makes a team difficult to trap when they have big guys or wing players that can handle the ball. Oh, nice slip pass, and the up and under is good. So Levin has all 7 points early for Long Beach State.
Well, he's off to a good start. Now we see a 1-2-2 half-court trap, and now dropping back to that 2-3 zone. You would hope that that wouldn't affect West Virginia with the experience they have at the guard position.
And in trouble. Nobody came to him. And here's Booker back the other way, and Booker is going to draw the foul attempt and a chance to shoot a couple of free throws. Deshaun Booker, the junior point guard, all three point guards for Long Beach State lost to graduation a year ago, so still working in Booker at that point guard position.
At the line for the 49ers.
Ogilu is the one that really goes to the hole hard, but when they get that opportunity, all these guys can drive it and drive it pretty good. He's the one that really goes hard.
Substitutions, three of them for the Mountaineers as Chase Harler comes in along with Magic Bender and freshman Teddy Allen. And Booker hits both free throws, and the lead is 6 for Long Beach State.
And there's that 1-2-2 full court pressure.
Excellent free throw shooting team. 79% free throw shooting team is Long Beach State. That's something to keep an eye on, that you don't want to necessarily allow them to get to the line with that kind of percentage. West. And that three-pointer good from the corner. He's hit a pair.
Well, Mountaineer fans have seen it. When West gets cranked up, he can really go.
And boy, on the other end, as Riggins went up for what appeared to be an easy basket, swatted away by West.
Lamont West really looks relaxed on his shot.
Here's Booker. Booker will pull up and in and out, rebound to West. So West, a strong beginning to this game for West Virginia. Head to Allen, and Allen was thinking pass before he looked the ball in, and so it's a turnover. Third turnover from the Mountaineers early. And substitution is Jordan Roberts comes into the game for Ogilu.
Bob Huggins not pleased with this crowd early on.
Well, here's a turnover for the Mountaineers. West thought about the three, faked it, lost the handle. And now that is taken by Long Beach State. Out of bounds, it will be Long Beach State basketball. Fourth turnover for the Mountaineers.
Unfortunate, West, I think, hit a slick spot on the court and lost his footing, and that resulted in that turnover.
Wesley Harris into the game for West Virginia.
Teams have a tendency early on to beat West Virginia's pressure. Morgan State didn't the other night, but it wears on you after a while. You see that relentless pressure, although West Virginia is not pressing quite as much as they did over the last couple
of years.
Another
turnover. Second turnover for Long Beach State.
Ball goes all the way back to the other end of the court. Was never touched by any player.
And we talked about that, you know. I think maybe losing Brandon Knapper, the freshman point guard, who was expected to be perhaps the backup point guard. That and no Issa Ahmad has really hurt their numbers early.
It has.
Bender was able to corral and save for the Mountaineers.
And Long Beach with really good quick hands early on.
Harler will try from three-point range, in and out. Rebound to Riggins.
Good box out by Riggins inside.
Dangerous pass attempt from Albert's knocked away. Back come the Mountaineers into the corner. Harris. And Harris will be called for an offensive foul.
Wesley Harris predetermined what he was going to do right away. Good slide over by Riggins.
Lamont West checks back in for the Mountaineers.
West back in for West Virginia. And the freshman from Finland. Ingenue will check into the game. Ingenue, a guy with some European tournament experience, has really been a surprising surprisingly good player for Dan Monson's team. They liked him, but he's come in and made an impact a little earlier than maybe some had forecast.
Yeah, he played on the junior national team in Finland, so he's got some experience.
And Junior now with the basketball. And in trouble, Chase Harlow with the steal. Spins. Can't get it to go, and the rebound hustling by Riggins. And Harlow thought he had a chance to finish there. The Long Beach State 49ers have rolled into the Coliseum. And after the first time out, leading West Virginia 9-6.
Well, 4.5 minutes into this one in Morgantown, the 49ers have a three-point lead over the Mountaineers at the Coliseum. I'm Robbie Smikowski. Well, with the start that Long Beach State has had to this game, you wouldn't tell that they've traveled almost all over the country in the last 2 days. As we get a look at what they were able to do, first of all, it started with a game in Corvallis, Oregon against Oregon State, 11 o'clock Eastern time. Then they flew from Portland to Phoenix, Phoenix to Pittsburgh, then took a bus to Morgantown, got in dinner time last night, shoot around this morning in the game tonight, and tomorrow the two teams will fly together. Almost 7,000 miles in total in this trip, Rob and Warren. And I tell you what, they're no worse for the wear in the travel and off to a quick start tonight against the Mountaineers.
You know, thanks, Robbie. And we talk about whether West Virginia's pressure can have an effect on them. You wonder if maybe that travel later in the game might have an effect on their legs as well.
Yeah, it may affect those legs a little later on, Rob. That's a good point.
And they're going to call a push as Majuni was shoved out of bounds, said the official, so a foul call on West Virginia.
Yeah, Mountaineer faces one on the
wall. Javon Carter, his first, team foul number four.
Oh, boy. Yeah, I think the Mountaineers had a case there.
Majuni drops down, and this time, Levin off the mark. That was challenged a little by Bender. Long Beach State back in that zone defense.
They do a good job of switching up. You have to communicate with that, because if someone's off the page, then it ends up being an easy shot.
Carter out, Harlow, three-pointer, and it's good for Chase Harlow.
Boy, Chase Harlow needed that.
A little lazy in that pass, but Majuni does get through. Three-pointer on the way is good. That is Brian Alberts, the Gonzaga transfer. Part of their team that went to the national championship a year ago, able to transfer and play right away because he's a graduate transfer.
Yeah. Now, he was going to be a good player at Gonzaga. They just set so many. It was a numbers thing, and he ended up deciding to move on.
Harlow will try another three, and that's good. Now, nice to see Chase Harlow from Moundsville, West Virginia, such a potent scorer in high school, find the range early. Back the other way, Alberts another three. This no good, running tip in by Levin. What a play.
And nobody got a body on Levin. He was able to run right down the lane and get that tip in.
Allen down low to Bender and back to Allen. Oh, missed the short one. Teddy Allen gets his own and follows it up.
Nice pass by Bender. Allen sticking with it. A lot of times guys have a tendency to fall away. He was right back there to get the rebound.
And Majuni called for the travel that the crowd wanted last time. This time, as Kanate, Miles, and Harris check back into the game.
See Dan Monson right there. He gets a lot of credit for the success Gonzaga has had in the past years, doing a lot for that program. Mark Few there now. And we know enough about Gonzaga.
A former assistant under Monson. And the follow-up missed. And Alberts checked in. Levin out for Long Beach State. Rebound to Kanate.
I'm interested to see Kanate and Riggins go each other inside. Both are big and physical.
Shot off the mark. Riggins goes 6'8", 230. Kanate listed as 6'8", 260. Should point out, as West Virginia fans know, Issa Ahmad out until January. Temedeo Youssef, who was a preseason All-Big West Conference along with Levin, and a big guy at 6'7", 265. He is recovering from meniscus surgery. and probably going to play this weekend. So, Warren, I know you're heading down to Orlando as we see the first of two free throws made by Harrison. A chance for you to see him there.
Yeah, well, I'm looking forward to seeing him. You know, and you know, Coach Munson said he probably could have played, but they don't want to risk anything. Obviously, they'd like to win this game, but their conference means a lot more to them.
There's a pull-up by Albert, who's missed his last couple. Rebound to Harris. Canate, strong move.
Strong move, Canate. Listen, that's going to be a big battle inside.
Ogilvie, nice move, hangs, but nothing called there. Now, loose ball battle. West Virginia comes up with it. And it's been called a jump ball as Harris tried to get the timeout call.
That's Ogilvie going to the basket hard. And he ran into one of those speed bumps just now when he saw Sags.
Right, exactly, one of your keys. The rest of the team, 11 is 4 for 5. The rest of the team, 1 for 7. Now here's the battle for the loose ball. And Ogilvie able to get a hand in there.
Yeah.
That'll be Long Beach State basketball.
Now, Nears wanted the timeout, but seeing that second look, I think that was a good call.
Riggins being guarded hard by Canate. Now Canate comes away with a steal. This is Bolden. And Bolden challenged, and Canate is fouled. But Bolden took it right at the bigger man, K.J. Byers. Missed, but good hustle and follow-up by Canate.
I don't know if Bolden knew that Canate was behind him. I was looking for him to drop that off for a huge
Sags,
slam.
At the free throw line for the Mountaineers, shooting two.
They got it up off. Or over Byers, just couldn't convert. Canate now hits the first of two free throws.
Saw Canate against Morgan State hit some of those free throw jumpers, mid-range jump shots. That is something that he's really been working on, and that's another element to his game he can add that will make him very, very tough. He's big, tough now.
Oh, okay. Big, strong player. It was his first made free throw. Had been 0 for 2 in the season. And just like that, he's a 50% free throw shooter. That's Levin, by the way, who's checked back in. Being guarded by Miles. And just West Virginia pressure really beginning to show up on Long Beach State here. Ogilvie, oh boy, through the legs of the defender, but Levin missed the fairly easy reverse layup, maybe aware of Canate's presence. Kick to the corner. Miles thought about it. Back top of the key. Harris three-pointer. No good. Oh, what a tip attempt by Carter. Levin with the rebound. Here's Ogilvie. Left hand no good. Rebound follow no good.
Ogilvie
LeRon
really
Williams
likes,
checked
to,
in.
Likes to go to that hole. But again, Canate back there, that is that enforcer that protects the rim.
Most dissuasive. West Virginia on a 7-0 run. Looking to add to a 5-point lead. Here's Canate. Oh, he read your mind.
Yes,
steps out for the 17-footer.
Really something he's worked on. He hit a couple against Morgan State. You see him in practice working on that. And most coaches, for the most part, like for a big guy to take that shot because that means he's not cleaning up the boards inside. But if he keeps hitting those shots like that, they're going to have to play him.
Here's Levin, and Levin ends the 9-0 West Virginia run. Levin has 11 points.
Boy, he came to play, playing really well. Back 2-3 zone now. You hope your veteran guards can always see that and get the team in the right position.
Carter skips to Bolden. Bolden's runner comes up short. Long shot attempt and a quick trigger. That shot was off the mark by Jordan Griffin. Now trailing back the other way, in and out.
Right now, Wesley Harris may get that shot eventually, but right now that's not his forte. I think he's better served to go inside and battle on the boards.
And done a nice job rebounding the Mountaineers, and they need the help with Ahmad out. Ogilvy turns the corner and the lead down for Williams, but before that happens, there's a personal foul. So 9:44 remaining in the first half. West Virginia leading Long Beach State 21-16.
There's a timeout.
Our Super Bowl looks at some of the action early on in this game, and it has been hotly contested. Long Beach State within 5 points of West Virginia, 21-16. The Mountaineers come in ranked 23rd in the AP. They have been ranked for 38 consecutive weeks and 59 straight weeks in the coaches' poll, coming in ranked number 20 in that poll. Long run of success under that man, Bob Huggins. Long Beach State to inbounds.
Chase Harler and Beetle Bolden will be the backcourt for the Mountaineers.
Levin's shot comes up short. Drop down. Williams. Oh, my. Kanate. Woo. Was that beautiful?
His timing is just unbelievable. What, the one thing that you like about Kanate is that he allows the offensive player to go first, and then he leaves the floor. So he very seldom gets caught off with a pump fake. He makes sure that that person is elevated before he leaves the floor, and then his timing is just tremendous.
Averaging 4 blocks a game and changing many more. Extra pass to West in the corner, and the rebound to Griffin.
Ron Carter didn't get much of a rest. He's back out there.
They're going to call Levin for the travel. That's almost, it seems, an automatic call now. Stop and pause and then put it down on the floor. That's called quite frequently.
Yes, it is. Chase Seven. Harler off with the quick start with the 6 points back in the ballgame for the Mountaineers.
Seven turnovers now for Long Beach State, as we point that out, as we're under 10 minutes. But pressure from West Virginia beginning to bear some fruit. And boy, Kanate, nice job with the square up. It looked like a shade of Warren Baker, a little jump hook there.
He dribbled it twice. I could only get down one time. One thing that Kanate did that time that was really good, we've seen the ball being taken from him a number of times. He only put it down for 2 dribbles.
Oh, my. Kanate is able to meet Ogilvy at the rim. And now the other way, Allen. Oh, and Kanate's follow-up jam, no good. But my, oh, my. Ogilvy came soaring in. What a block by Kanate.
Again, look at the timing. Not to get a foul, nobody, excellent. And Ogilvy was up there pretty good.
Wow.
I think he had visions of dunking that.
He definitely
yes.
did. Different visions for Kanate as Allen hits the first free throw.
Mason Riggin and Jordan Roberts check in for the 49ers.
Riggins and Roberts in for Long Beach State as Allen gets his second free throw attempt. Freshman averaging almost 9 points a game. And here's it looked like they were sorting out some of their pressure defense after that made free throw. Backdoor cut. Levin in trouble. Boy, Kanate was able to challenge that, but Riggins, who's now 9 for 10 from the floor this season, just like those garbage baskets.
Yeah.
And, boy, coaches appreciate players that play like that. Riggins not averaging a lot of points, but making his shots count. Long Beach State in his own defense. Get it to the middle to Allen, and Allen, nice spin move in the lane.
Good work by Allen at that free throw line.
Backdoor cut to Roberts. Oh, tried to go extra pass to Riggins, a little too crisp through his fingers. The Mountaineers have extended their lead to 27-18, creating 8 turnovers and a pair of blocks from Kanate. The Mountaineers up with 7:38 remaining first half.
If we can get a lead without Carter or Miles scratching, we're in pretty good shape.
For different reasons. So I think Carter very content to try to get his teammates involved early as the point guard.
Man-to-man, Long Beach State out of the timeout.
Here's Chase Harder on the floor, blocked from behind, out of bounds, and it will remain West Virginia basketball. 51. Out of step, Roberts at 6'8", able to reach in and bat that away. A little bit of a step in for West Virginia. Long Beach State remaining in the man-to-man. Carter back to Bolden. Bolden three, no good. Route the rebound, and this is knocked away. But once again, the Mountaineers with a turnover. Carter is able to lay it up over Riggins.
One of those types of turnovers that Coach Munson just hates to see. Careless with the basketball.
Griffin skips. Roberts open extra pass inside. A really nice pass by Jordan Roberts. Passed up the open three. And Riggins will go to the free throw line.
Good decision by Beetle Bolden. You usually see Javon Carter doing that, but Bolden rewarding him with a nice pass.
Two free throws.
The two free throws that Riggins shooting now. Miscommunication by West Virginia on defense. And it started a chain reaction with Riggins getting the ball late and by himself. You've got to talk and make sure that everybody knows the rotation.
That was the first made free throw for Mason Riggins. I'd be surprised if he wanted to bank that in. See what his approach is on the second.
Yeah, it looked like it may have been
tough to say in between on that one. Good hustling, hard-nosed player, Mason Riggins for Long Beach State. Back into the zone. Oh, no, it's man-to-man, I beg your pardon. Under 10 on the shot clock now. Carter the drive, the pump fake. Oh, and the finish. Pretty by Javon Carter.
Took his time, did just enough, got the nut in the air, faded away. Nice shot.
Booker in the corner. Roberts. And the freshman off the mark. Rebound to Riggins. Riggins trying to go up now, left hand, and Mason Riggins, boy, he is just strong from the floor. 10 for 11 now this year.
You have to get a body on him inside. He and the big center for Oregon State the other night watching it, he and Eubank really had a battle. I was looking forward to see him, Kanate, go at it.
Now, Riggins, they gave him, they're calling him 2 for 3 from the floor. I don't remember the miss, so still very impressive from the floor. And now West Virginia. One of those things where you're battling each other for the ball as Kanate will check back in.
Sykes Kanate checks in.
And Brian Alberts for Long Beach State.
Unusual. Everything Beetle Bolden has put up has been short at this point.
And Mishuni check in for the 49ers.
He's been such a sharp shooter for the Mountaineers, Beetle Bolden.
The days of him sneaking up on someone shooting are over. I heard the bench, Long Beach State bench, yelling shooter when he got the ball.
And Majuni turns this one over as Javon Carter, just so good defensively. And here's Bolden open for three, too strong this time. Ogulu in the corner, and they'll pull it back out. Spinning around, Alberts, three-pointer, and this one is good. So Brian Alberts had begun the game cold, but now hits that three-pointer. Now 2 for 4 from the floor.
And he's the type of guy that can really get on a roll. So you're going to have to make sure when you come back in transition, you find him.
Carter has this one blocked away by Riggins. Good ball movement
by Long Beach State. Results in a nice shot. West Virginia's defense a little slow in reacting.
Well, they got beaten down the floor, didn't they? Then they began to run around a little bit.
Caused the chain reaction.
West will try a three-pointer. Oh, my. Lamont West is hot.
West for three.
Oh, when you mentioned Albert's starting to feel it. Lead is 8. Man defense off the switch. West gets himself open. Oh, as Byers commits the personal foul. I thought that might go in and a chance for a 4-point play. West will have 3 free throws though when we return with the Mountaineers up by 8.
Boy, Sykes Konate's been all over the place. See him hitting that little jumper. He's hit a couple of little shots inside. One power dribble all the way to the hole. He's been getting in trouble by dribbling more. And then at the other end, go in at your own risk. I'm back here. You better know. And a little Mutombo action right there. Don't come in there when I'm down there.
8 minutes, 3 for 3 to the floor, 2 for 2 from the free throw line, 8 points, a pair of blocks for Sags Konate. The Mountaineers enjoying an 8-point lead.
Lamont West.
As West goes to the line, he will shoot 3. West has 9 points. Remain there. Does hit the second.
Now, West did miss the first free throw. But, you know, I've noticed there's a lot of guys that really shoot threes well that struggle. Not that he's going to.
Definitely.
But, yeah.
Absolutely. 1 for 3 from the free throw.
Two out of three there. Guys that can shoot the three all the time and then struggle.
Now, Ogilvy did not like what he was seeing with Sags Konate that time.
And Ogilvy loves to drive, but not this time.
Byers tries to turn the corner. Three-pointer off the mark, batted out of bounds by West. It will be Long Beach State basketball. It was Majunu who attempted that three. And they're going to get Konate on the reach. And boy, you hate to see that. You want him playing that good man-to-man, and Levin is a guy that can hit the three-pointer, so you have to worry about that. Shot 33% from three-point range a year ago, but we don't want him reaching in that far away from the basket.
No,
Booker checks back in for 49ers.
The fouls that Konate gets, you want to have a physical variety inside if he's going to pick one up. Not 20 feet from the basket.
1-1, and they missed the front end. Again, mentioned nearly an 80% free throw shooting team. Cost them a chance to try to get 2. 9-point West Virginia lead.
1-2-2 zone now by Long Beach State. Again, they try to keep you off balance.
As a player, how difficult is that, Warren, to adjust to?
It's not really that difficult when you have guards like West Virginia has that can recognize it and let everybody know and get them in good position.
Oh, Konate continuing his excellent shooting.
Teams are going to have to start coming out on him, which will then open up some driving lanes for the guards.
Lofted shot, Konate changing that from Ogilu. And now Javon Carter, that is out of bounds. We go over to Robbie Inzbikowski. Robbie.
Well, guys, in 2 minutes and 43 seconds, we have our halftime report coming up here on AT&T Sportsnet. We'll talk to WVU Athletic Director Shane Lyons. We'll talk about the 4-year extension recently signed by Bob Huggins, plus stats and highlights between this game. Long Beach State and West Virginia, guys, just a couple minutes away.
Jordan Roberts.
Looking forward to that.
49ers.
Bob Huggins has a chance to continue to move up in the all-time wins list. Ooh, barely kept alive. Now Levin will try the three. Levin will hit.
Three-pointer by Levin.
Boy, Levin continues his excellent start to this game. He has 14 points. West will try to answer. His three-point attempt short, but was able to get the long rebound. Zone defense from Long Beach State. Konate stepping further out. His first miss from the floor. Booker up in transition. Other way, three-pointer out by Albertson. Harris able to rebound.
Well, Albertson had a good look. West Virginia fortunate.
Now Harler will try from three, and Chase Harler is good. His third three-pointer.
Beetle Bolden not having the stroke tonight. Chase Harlett in the ball game does.
And Levin, the foul will be called on Wesley Harris.
Javon Carter knows where the hot hand is. Harlett was ready, pulled the trigger without hesitation, shooting the ball with a lot of confidence.
Mason Riggins for the 49ers.
So Chase Harlett. He has 9 points. That matches a career high for him.
Gabe Levin.
Lots of basketball to play here.
One and the ball.
And Levin hits the front end of the one-on-one this time. Mentioned earlier his performance is against big schools. 17 points, 10 rebounds against North Carolina. Last year, 12 points and 12 rebounds against Louisville. 12 and 7 against Oregon State. The Loyola Marymount transfer. We were talking to Dan Monson about him before the game. Said Notre Dame, other big schools, Marquette wanted him, so he is a high-level player.
Player, yes.
Carter, nice move, couldn't finish. Levin the rebound. Trying to get it to single digits here. And Roberts. Well, he thought maybe that was deflected. I thought it might have been deflected as well, but no call.
Roberts saw that truck and Kanante coming at him and really did not. He may have
tough to say if that hit off the arm of Carter or not.
He had really nothing to do with it. As Bob Huggins says, sometimes you're going to turn it over, at least throw it out of bounds. That'll give us a chance to get back on defense.
And Kanate right there for the follow-up. He's nearing a career high as well.
Good
to the top comes Allen. Harler, three-pointer. Good for Chase Harler.
Boy, and is he on fire tonight.
New career high for Chase Harler. Pull up, off the mark, Allen the rebound. And Harler thought about pulling
it.
One more. And Bob Fire Huggins on. Wants a timeout with about a 4-second differential between the game shot and the shot clock. So, wow, what a run here for West Virginia. Able to begin to pull away late, up 15 in a game that has just sort of leaked away from Long Beach State. And the Mountaineers up 15 as Chase Harler continues to be hot.
You know, it's been the Harler outside, Kanate inside ball game here the last 10 minutes or so.
Chase Harler 4-for-5 from three-point range. A career high of 12 points already for Chase Harler. Kanate has 12, his career high is 13, so some things to keep an eye on as this game unfolds. Chase Harler having his best game, certainly his best half as a Mountaineer.
Certainly. Beetle Bolden back in. West Virginia looking to get another shooter on the court. Even though Beetle hadn't hit one, you know that at any time he can explode.
Carter, very smart. We've seen teams that don't appear to know that rule sometimes against West Virginia. They're inbounding at half court. Use that whole court, right? Because West Virginia, when they can pressure you, very, very difficult. Now Carter on the penetration, lost the handle, out of bounds. It will remain, though, West Virginia basketball.
Carter to penetrate and then kick either side if the defense collapses on him. But he had a lane all the way to the basket, had it knocked away. 3 seconds on the shot clock. West Virginia's got to get a quick shot off.
And they try to the lob to Kanate, gets it off, and draws the foul.
Wow.
Long Beach State foul holder number 3, Jordan Roberts.
And it's going to be on Jordan Roberts, the 6'8" freshman. So Kanate a chance to buy himself and his team a couple more points.
Thanks, Kanate. 2 shots.
Daxter Miles ready to check in, probably for Beetle Bolden.
And Kanate with that free throw, tying his career high. 3-for-3 from the free throw line, 5-for-6. He had 13 against TCU a season ago. And now has a new career high, 14 first half points for Sags Kanate. Booker, tough shot, blocked by Carter. Oh, suffocating defense.
Wow.
And West Virginia against a good Long Beach State team. That's a pretty good first half of basketball for the Mountaineers, especially for Kanate, West, Harler, 47-30 as we head over to Robbie Inzmikowski.
Yeah, Rob, we're going to ask Bob about those three guys. Kanate, West, and Harler, three guys you're going to build around for the next couple seasons, Bob. How have they each been able to mature and grow into your system?
Well, they made shots that nobody else did. Sags is a rim protector, but he's always been that. He's worked hard at his game. We got to get Lamont and Beadle making shots.
How about, we're going to discuss Kanate here for just a second, the highlight reel block. How has that aspect of his game maybe helped the other aspects of his game, the shot blocking skill that he possesses so naturally?
I don't think it has a bit. He gets in the gym and works. He puts time in. That's what it's all about, is repetition.
Thanks, Bob.
Yep.
All right, Rob?
Robbie, thanks very much. So a good first half for the Mountaineers. Up 47-30, Long Beach State hanging in there, but West, Harler, Kanate, and company helping the Mountaineers pull away in the waning moments of that first half. Halftime show's coming up. Right in front of our broadcast position. Inbounding to Javon Carter, second half underway. Man-to-man defense.
Good job by Kanate, not forcing anything.
Miles hands off to Carter, back to Miles. Kanate trying to go to work on Riggins, jump up. Oh my, is Kanate feeling it? Reaching deep into the toolbox.
Yes, he is. I thought Riggins, based on what I had seen up to this point, would give him more resistance.
Oh, and Ogulu has it swatted by Kanate. Third block, not sure that didn't go off of, yeah, it did. It went off of Ogulu, who will be West Virginia basketball.
Wow. Sags is really showing all elements of his game. The timing, the ability to stay up there and be patient. You see a lot of guys swat down, and that's where they pick the fouls up.
Yeah, and the shot blockers, as you know, not only affecting the shots that they block, but when someone drives in, they've got one eye in the basket and one eye in Kanate. Miles left hand, no good. Kanate hit it and Levin kept it alive, where it's tracked down by Alberts. Up ahead, oh, this time Kanate couldn't quite get to that one. It'll be a pair of free throws for Long Beach State. It's Ogulu looking for his first points of the game.
Number one. Ogulu, their leading scorer, West Virginia, doing a nice job. Driving to the basket is his forte. That's what he loves to do.
Transfer from Yuba Community College, and he said at one time he was a walk-on.
He was a walk-on. I bet there's a lot of schools looking around saying, geez, I wish I'd have known that. I certainly would have offered. He didn't stay a walk-on long at Long Beach State, but he was a walk-on when he first got there.
Averaged 5 points a game last year, 17 this year. Miles and Bob Huggins to the left of your screen.
And one,
now
two,
right
two.
In the middle, having a discussion. Which will result in Miles taking a seat. Harler coming into the game for the Mountaineers. Carter kicks back to West. West, oh my, Lamont West feeling it from outside. Then trying to get the ball inbound, and finally does to Alberts. Lead is 20. And then backdoor. Ogulu. Oh. Kanate with that great timing. Fourth block for Sags Kanate. Looking at the crowd, those guys say, why do they keep coming in here?
Look again. He waits till the offensive player leaves the floor. And then he goes up with that great timing.
Now we look at that rejection. Here's Alberts, and Alberts hits a three-pointer, able to shake loose for a moment. That's all it took for Brian Alberts, who was beginning to heat up as that first half expired. 11 points now for the Gonzaga transfer.
Well, he didn't go to Gonzaga initially without being able to play. They've had some pretty good players. Again, it was just a numbers thing, and he wanted to play more, and I don't blame him either. But certainly he has the ability.
Here's Carter. He will pull up, and Javon Carter. Well, he has not forced anything here, has he, in this game?
No, he has not.
Now the pressure. Carter with the steal. Looking up, sees Harris, and Harris can't finish. And a little shove, little 15-on-15 shove there as Booker got a little underneath. And that will be the foul call as both he and West battling for the rebound.
Real inexperience. That's one of those ones that he should have given up. Harris got the ball, give it right back to Carter for an easy layup. He put up an awkward shot that didn't go down. West being fortunate that there was a foul.
Carter step back, fall away, and it is good for Javon Carter, long two-pointer. Alberts, then middle of the floor, Booker three-pointer, and it's good for Deshaun Booker. Good ball movement there by Long Beach State.
Long Beach State is not going to quit. In watching them play Oregon State the other night, they had the chances to fold three or four times. Oregon State would go up at 12. They'd cut it back to four.
West, pump fake, and wow, is Lamont West on fire for the Mountaineers.
Who's feeling it more, he or Harlow? My goodness.
Oh, and that time, Riggins taking it strong, and he is fouled as he goes up for the jam, and have a chance to shoot a pair of free throws.
Lamont West trying to get into the blocking action. He went up strong. Got Riggins on the arm.
At the line for Long Beach State, Mason Riggins with two shots.
See Riggins have some uncomfortable looking moments at the free throw line. Bender checks in.
Riggins very fortunate that the student body is not in full force. He'd be hearing it the rest of the night.
Absolutely. And he hits the second. Nice to see him step up and knock that one down. Cuts the lead back to 20. West is going to try another. Oh, my. That was... Even for the red-hot West, that one maybe just a little too far out.
I think it's outside the area code on that one.
Corner, Majuni now. The kick opposite corner, and Alberts couldn't corral in bounds. That is the 14th turnover for Long Beach State.
Cumulative effect, that pressure and pressure and more pressure. You start getting sloppy, you get a little tired, and that's when those type of mistakes happen.
Well, and you know, you don't want to excuse them, because I'm sure they won't, you know, one excuse is made for him, but we talked about that long travel across the country playing Oregon State, 11 p.m. our time that game started, and then getting on a plane at 5 o'clock in the morning in Portland as Allen has it blocked by Riggins. And the lead is 20. 15:48 remaining. The Mountaineers up 59-39. Bob Huggins and the Mountaineers return to AT&T Sportsnet on Thursday, November 30th at 7 p.m. when they host the Highlanders of NJIT. The Mountaineers are led in scoring by senior guard Daxter Miles Jr., who's coming off his career-high 32 points versus Morgan State, all part of wild and wonderful sports coverage. Well, the Mountaineers have had several heroes. There we saw Logan Rout with a career-high, Daxter Miles a career-high, Sags Kanate and Chase Harler have career-highs.
A correction to make.
Peter Bolin has had a career high this year.
Yep.
Well, you know, it's going to be like that. And you know, Bob Huggins will keep working until he finds the guys with the hot hand. But it's good to see that you've got multiple people that may be able to come in and step up.
We were talking about Teddy Allen, who goes to the free throw line here and misses the first. And you said he's going to be one of those guys where you look up and he's got more than you thought, and in 7 minutes in the first half, he was halfway to a double-double, 6 points and five rebounds, somewhat quietly. And adding to that total here early on in the second half.
He's going to do a lot of grunt work, get in and root, and you know, come up with some loose balls, stick them back.
Strong, tough, hard-nosed player, three-pointer, too strong. Tip attempt by Levin is no good. Carter comes back the other way, the blow-by, but He's able to get his own back after he was batted away by Alberts.
How quick did he get that ball back and block?
Such a hard worker. Talk to him. You know, you mentioned in our last broadcast that he didn't come here as a point guard. I asked him this morning. He came in, was shooting around by himself at the gym. Nice little dump down to Levitt as West Virginia a little confused there defensively. He really grew to the point guard role, he thought, after his sophomore year. His last couple years, he's really felt like a point guard.
Well, having Juwan Staten to model yourself after certainly didn't hurt either.
Here's Bender going to work. Bender has it blocked by Riggins. Kept alive, and Riggins able to control, looking for some help, and finally finds Booker. Alberts. Carter recovering quickly. Mountaineers can get back into their defense. Backcourt, and Levitt able to sneak in the jam.
That's two defensive breakdowns with Levitt on the baseline. Lack of communication and then a slow rotation. In any event, it's resulted in 4 points for Levin the last couple of times down.
11, 19 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists. Now one step through. Winds up being a lob to Bender, who's fouled and left against shooting free throws.
Long Beach State foul call number 10, Brian Alberts.
Nice look from Majuni.
I'm not so sure that was Harlow's man. Again, the rotation was slow. Bender needed to get over a little quicker, but West Virginia's got to clean that up. That's twice in a row that Levin has been wide open underneath. I don't know if that would have gone down had Sags been in there, but.
Well, Bender, one of those guys, you know, you see the talent, and it might just take a little while, but he's got some abilities.
I asked guys that shoot around today, has anybody ever seen him mad? Maybe he needs a good shot to the chops to see what happens if he gets real upset one time. Because he's a very passive young man. And it shows on the court sometimes.
Majuni, a little miscommunication with Alberts. Judy out. And Javonte Jackson will check into the game. And West was thinking about it. They closed out pretty quickly that time. Carter was trying to get it back out to West for the three, just lost the handle.
One of the few times you see Javon Carter get too deep.
Albert to the three-pointer. This lead is somewhat quietly now, but cut down to 16.
Again, they could have folded a number of times against Oregon State, and they didn't do it. Now another turnover.
Foul called on Bender.
Bender.
KJ Myers.
Deontay in. KJ Myers in for 11. Officials want a timeout. That's a substitution somewhat late for Levin, able to get over to the bench. Alberts with Carter guarding. Carter just pounding it. Alberts will pull up and shot off the mark. Be a foul called on West Virginia. Teddy Allen is going to be called for the personal foul. Long Beach looking to add to a 7-0 run over the last minute and 50 seconds.
That time down, Alberts looked like, I'm going to take this shot. I'm going to take it on maybe the best defensive player in the year, but I'm going to get it off.
Alberts, three-pointer, short, rebound, Kanate, and took some contact over the top, so they're going to say Riggins batted it out of bounds, and no personal foul will be called. Looked like Kanate.
May have
they didn't call that a foul, then, well, you know, she could say it looked like it was off Kanate, but it also looked like it might have been a foul, so. That'll play on. The corner, Carter thought about it. Tried to leave it to Kanate. Riggins really read that well.
Boy, rare to see JC have two turnovers back-to-back. And there's a backcourt violation.
Long Beach State a couple of chances to cut into this lead, and some empty trips down the floor. The lead remains 16 as Carter will get a rest and Beetle Bolton will check into the game. See the scoring drought here for West Virginia. Twelve on the shot clock. Bolden to Harler. Harler's three-pointer short. Canate did not have to jump. Got it, ooh, but had it blocked from behind. Nice job by KJ Byers. Now here's Byers in the corner for three, and too strong. Rebound to Jackson. Jackson will chip pitch out, and now they're going to have a stop. And we have a timeout on the floor, so officials are going to call both teams over to the sideline. A timeout has been called. Lead is at 62-46 for West Virginia. Long Beach State has hung in there. Sags Canate has had a career game thus far. Lamont West has been banging down three-pointers for West Virginia. Long Beach State, though, still with 16 points. They've been able to use West Virginia 14 offensive rebounds to their advantage, but, you know, not a huge rebounding edge. We look at this, and really, you look at Long Beach State unable to get any points off their bench in this game. 36 minutes, no points. Levin taking to the basket and looking like he wanted to draw the foul. Canate is called for the foul, and that helps him up.
His third,
number five. Yep, got him with the lower body. They're going to call that. The official standing right there. Had basically the same vantage point.
So you think it wasn't a late reach, you think? You think it was down low to the contact?
Yes. Okay.
11 hits the first free throw. As we mentioned, a 79% free throw shooting team. So if you're eyeing down the road in West Virginia, you don't want to let this game get close. Talk about the jinx factor. And they're a very good free throw shooting team.
This team has no quit in them. They're going to fight you.
Bolden in trouble, gets to the middle of the floor to Harler. And out of Miles, back to Bolden. And so now with 15 in the shot clock, the Mountaineers trying to get into their offense. And they have a foul underneath. I believe it's going to be on Javonte Jackson. Yeah, it was. Chasing Lamont West along the baseline.
Javonte Jackson, his first.
The first personal for Jackson. Oh, Miles, they just left him alone.
Jack Miles.
Boy.
Chase Harler.
As a coach, you hate to see your team doze off when a team takes the ball out underneath. They get an easy layup like that.
First points, by the way, for Dax Miles coming off that 32-point performance against Morgan State. 11 with a pass underneath. Jackson, the bounce to 11. Nobody wants to take it up with Canate down there.
Nice. Nice rotation.
I think you can credit that turnover to Canate on the other end, swatted away by Byers. And nobody wanted anything to do with Canate.
That's a good block here, too. A lot of body there, but the officials cannot see it.
Byers over the top.
Getting behind.
17 turnovers for Long Beach State, and Canate won't get credit for that turnover, but he certainly caused it. It's almost comical. I mean, they kept passing it in a ring around Canate.
Like
yep.
One who's going to sit beside him on the flight. They are chartering together to Orlando tomorrow. He may be blocking somebody's couple on the plane tomorrow.
Bolden gets it inbounds to West. Under 11 minutes remaining, a 17-point lead for West Virginia. Maybe not quite comfortable yet. Canate, my oh my, what a game for Sags Canate.
Riggins is the only one that has any strength close to stopping and he's on the bench right now. He had 11 on him and just said, give me the ball. I know what to do with it.
Well, Temanayo Yusuf, as we mentioned, is their most physical player preseason Big West selection, as we see the step back from Booker. Nice spoke of him. 6'7", 265 would have been interesting
had he been
healthy enough, but coming off the meniscus, and they're hoping that he will play down in Orlando in the Advocare Invitation.
I think they played Missouri's first ball game. That's just a really, really good contest.
Kanate thinking about it. We'll pull up. Oh, my. Sags Kanate showing everything inside, outside on the defensive end. Bob Huggins praising his hard work, and boy, really coming to fruition here. 20.7 rebounds, four block shots. Here's Alberts now. He'll be open for three. And Alberts hits the three.
Beetle Bowlin got caught looking ahead, trying to come up for the steal. And when he left Alberts, as soon as Alberts got the ball, he released it quickly, and you saw the results.
And Long Beach State staying within reach. Lead is 16. Haven't really had that 7-0 run that got it down under 20. Here's Bolden's three-pointer, and Peter Bolden. So Bolden had been 0 for 5 until he hit that three-pointer.
And he's a guy like West that can get on a run once he hits one.
Levin inside to Byers. Byers back to Levin. He fall away, no good. Then we wonder about the Kanate factor on that shot selection.
He fell away. He would have never fallen away had Kanate not been in the game.
Harder down to Bolden. And Bolden off the window. Oh, what a tip in. Soaring in for Lamont West.
I'm going to talk about some athleticism now. Wow.
Left to right, reaching across the rim, off the window, and good. Now Levin tries to come back the other way, and well, he showed some hops himself there.
Well, it's cold on second
ball. Oh, boy, I tell you what. Bob Huggins cannot believe it.
He does not like the call on Kanate.
I thought Shore was going against Levin.
Levin has not been his usual steady self from the free throw line. As we take a look at this last personal foul.
Wow.
Well, we just caught the tail end of that, and Kanate, as Levin's second one is good. Kanate, he should have a right to that basketball, right?
Yes, he should.
So he's moving to his right. Levin is the guy coming in from behind normally, or frequently, I should say. You would see that as an over-the-back call. Carter's drive, no good. Levin with the rebound. Levin able to track down. Mizzouni. Kicks, but now that he's slowed down here by Ogilvie. Ogilvie tries to track down his own, but instead it's going to be Lamont West. And West hangs and is fouled by Levin. Well, Sagabon Kanate, 20 points, 7 rebounds, and protecting the rim for the Mountaineers. West Virginia up 20, 73 to 53. 7:50 remaining in the second half. Well, earlier today at the Coliseum in Morgantown, we showed up for the morning shoot-around for Long Beach State, but before their noon shoot-around, I guess he was shooting around. Javon Carter, so I said, yeah, I'll rebound for you and pass. By the way, the guys in the Y, I'll tell you, that's more passing than I would do in a year,
yeah.
Right?
The first assist you got, too.
But, I mean, he was just shooting and making three after three after three. Long Beach State left. Guess who came back out to shoot some more? Javon Carter.
Exactly. I bet most people don't know that you were a college quarterback. And you did some passing there, too.
Yeah, but usually to the wrong team, unfortunately.
You weren't Nate Biederman yesterday, were you?
I had my struggles.
Day.
Yeah, that was too bad to see.
Oh.
And, you know, Carter, yeah, I talked to him about this and the adjustments at the point guard position. And, you know, a lot of times in garbage time, you'll see some teams, they're not good habits, but guys will start thinking about stuff in their stat sheet And you know, I said, Javon, you don't do that. He said, no, all he wants to do is win. All yes. he cares about. Oh, my Riggins.
That's good by Riggins.
Continuing that high shooting percentage.
Well, the big cat wasn't in there, and so the mice could play. And he went right down the middle. In that 2-3 zone.
I've really been impressed with Carter. They're not forcing things.
Right.
Rare miss by West, kept alive by Bender, then he and Bolden colliding. Lets the game come to him, and then his, you know, at the end of the game, the points, the rebounds, the assists, and the victories will be there.
That's right. With authority.
Chase Harler checks in for the Mafia.
Now Yusuf comes back, and they can move Riggins to a power forward. Boy, that tell you what, that's going to be a tough combination inside.
Well, the other thing is that normally this is a bench that's been productive for Dan Monson. No points off the bench in this game. For Long Beach State, that's amazing.
Yes, it is.
They've gotten plenty of time. They just have not been productive. He's one of those guys that can score off the bench. Griffin finds himself in trouble.
Excellent defense. Good trap. Harler and West really had nowhere to go with the basketball. Created that turnover. Nobody reached in. That's the big thing. You got him trapped. He can't go anywhere. Well, there is a reach.
You know what, though? You could get away with an awfully lot when you're in good position.
That's exactly right.
Remember being out in St. Louis when Charlie Spoonhauer was out there at St. Louis University. And they got away with a lot. It seemed Bob Huggins is coaching in Cincinnati at that time. So, you know, they'd get guys trapped and a lot of bumping.
Harder just kind of shoved that one up. Tough break.
Ogilu down the lane, and Harler doing a nice job tying him up. Will be Long Beach Come State on. Basketball.
Possession arrow to the 49ers. Albert, Hooker, and Williams check in for Long Beach
Chase
State.
Harler's had a fine game, his finest, I think, as a Mountaineer. After the high assist total at Morgan State, maybe getting a little more comfortable here. And that's the attempt 11, and now a jump ball will go in favor of West Virginia.
The good thing that you saw out of Harlan tonight, this wasn't mop-up time. He came in when the Mountaineers really needed him. You know, it's easy to come in if the game's a 20-20 game and shoot something up and it goes down. But he came in at a time when West Virginia really needed his offense.
A 4-for-6 from three-point range. And you know, you come out 0-for-4, right? This is an 8-point game. But Harler doing a nice job as Miles now, the three-pointer well off the mark. Rebound to Bender. Bender slides to West. And West is fouled. As he will have a chance to shoot a couple of Ron Williams, a sophomore, picks up the personal foul.
22, LaRon Williams called.
Harler playing additional minutes tonight, 27 minutes in this ball game, and he's earned.
11, the double-double. And 21 points and 10 rebounds. We mentioned his big games against the likes of North Carolina and Louisville and Loyola Marymount transfer, showing up big in games against big conference teams as West hits the first free throw. And West hits the second free throw. Now 22 points for Lamont West.
West Harris checks in for the Mountaineers.
Harris will check in. In case you're wondering, West at 27. You might remember that game against Oklahoma State last
year.
Levin, the step back inside. And Williams misses and still no points off the bench for Long Beach State.
Not a good decision by Wesley Harris. Tried to make that pass through the crease. Get the ball back to Miles and let him rotate it around. And luckily, that ball was not picked off because it was telegraphed.
Chase Harler holding his right hand a little bit as he steps to the free throw line.
Chase Harler at the free throw line. One and the ball.
Chase doesn't want anything to happen to that trigger finger when he's been shooting.
And hits the first. You know, interesting to talk about three-point shooters and where they find the range. Over three from the floor, and he's had a couple of layups that he's missed in this game.
That's right. Speaking of fingers, you wish Will Greer the best in his recovery.
Absolutely.
After having surgery.
14 points for Harlow as he continues to add to his career high. Booker being pressured, and now they're going to call Harlow.
Yep, and that was a good call.
Chase Harlow is called for the personal, his first, team foul number 7.
Harlow checks out.
Teddy Yellen checks into the mound.
Right hand, kind of still looking at it. Bob Huggins says, what'd you do?
The line for the 49ers.
Shake off the team kind of shaking that right hand. 1-1 for Booker. Man, the free throw line as the foul again by Williams. Long Beach State is really, it's really been a strength to their team. They're going to look up and see 9 of 16 and a few of those on the front end of 1-on-1s. And, you know, that's leaving, you know, potentially 6 points out there on the floor.
You
know, Long Beach State played at Corvallis at Oregon State Saturday night. You know, that trip may at this particular time begin to take its toll on them.
Booker up ahead, Alberts losing the handle.
Yeah, your focus when you've seen this type of pressure the entire game is very, very difficult to keep.
Alberts off mark as Allen pulls down the rebound. Carter really staying disciplined here.
Yeah.
Harris will go to work. Tried to sneak past Levin, but caught himself a trip to the free throw line.
11 called for the personal, his fourth. He fouls number 9.
Boy, get on that flight and then have to go to, no direct flights into Pittsburgh. Go to Phoenix, change there, and then come on into Pittsburgh and then bust down. They'll probably sleep well on that flight to Orlando tomorrow.
I'm heading down there to play in the same tournament as the Mountaineers. Interesting that they'll be hopping aboard the Mountaineers charter.
Sure.
Yeah. They'll, I'm sure, be a little weary.
Oh.
They've come in here and give it a good
counting
of themselves. Here's Griffin again off the mark, and Allen with the rebound.
Good decision by Miles. Eat some clock. Didn't force anything.
Lead up to 25 now. And Javon Carter will pull from 3. And again, staying within the offense. Javon Carter popping out to knock down a 3-pointer. 13 points for him. And 6 assists. As the Mountaineers pulling away now late, up 28, 83 to 55. Now the West Virginia Mountaineers leading 83 to 55, 3:51 remaining against Long Beach State. Mountaineers a good bet, obviously, to improve to 3-1 here. Their upcoming games as they head down to Orlando, Marist, and winner of Nebraska UCF would be the next one, the Advocare Invitational. We have New Jersey Institute of Technology, and then a couple tough ones against Virginia, and then at Pitt, always a rivalry game.
Interesting to see that UCF, Taco Falls, 7'6". You know, but he weighs about 170. You can move him around, but that's a tall gentleman.
11 hits the first. Now, how would you, at 6'7", have taken it at a 7'6" player?
You get into his knees. Guys that big don't like people bumping around their knees. So a lot of times that'll bring them down to your size.
As I said, of course, those knees are up to your waist.
Your waist, right? Yeah. They're right there at elbow height.
And Levin hits them both.
Also Levin, checking in, KJ Myers.
23 points now, that ties his career high.
The question is, can West Virginia shut out the bench?
That is really amazing.
3:50 left. Can they shut out the bench? I don't think I've ever seen a game where only 5 guys scored.
That bench, again, is seeing some minutes. They just have not been able to score. three-pointer, no good. Rebound. Harris in there for the jam.
Wesley Harris.
Lead now at 28 points for West Virginia. Alberts, another three-pointer, and this one is good for
three-pointer by Alberts.
For Alberts, that is a new career high for him. He had 19 in Oregon State. And obviously, again, oh, the alley-oop jam to Miles.
Boy, what a nice pass from Carter, and the timing.
That three-pointer off the mark from Alberts.
No question about Dax Miles Hopps. He is really up there. Good screen set by Wes Harris on the backside, too. Right there. He's got the screen down, which frees that lane up for Miles to come down and get the slam. Everybody doing their job. That doesn't work without a good screen.
Right. Under 2.5 minutes remaining. West Virginia comfortably out in front. D'Angelo Hunter's checked into the game. Carter's three-pointer off the mark. Back the other way comes Griffin. Yep, a little miscommunication. Ogulu will check back in the game.
Chase Harler and Beetle Bolden check in for the Mountaineers. Mary Ogulu for the 49ers.
And Javon Carter gets a big hand as he checks out of the game, as well as Daxter Miles. And Carter's night apparently done. 13 points, 7 assists. Ogulu, good job on defense. Great job on defense. Not good job on defense. Griffin three-pointer, too strong. And Alberts tried to follow up out of bounds. Bigger part than Byers trying to follow up as Logan Round into the game for Magic Bender.
Magic Bender, that last pass was just everybody in the building could see where he wanted to throw that pass.
D'Angelo Hunter coming off a good game against Morgan State. Seeing some late minutes here for the Mountaineers. A good pass from Bolden, able to step into that three-pointer.
That's not the easiest thing to do, sit over there for 35, 36 minutes and come in and light one up right away.
The Mountaineers have some guys that can shoot it. Griffin's three-pointer no good. And it just goes out of bounds. That bench still looking for its first points. But I mean, you talk about West with the instant offense, and you can bring Bolden off the bench. A mix.
Harler.
Right, Harler, exactly. You have a mix of your usual, hard-nosed, long, athletic players you can press and some guys that can give you some points. It could be an interesting team for West Virginia. Especially against Issa Ahmad back in January.
Double high screen set for Beetle Bolden.
Hunter will try another three. This one off the mark. Byers soars for the rebound. Under a minute remaining, and this ball is knocked away by Hunter, who
did not have to jump.
No, and I don't know if he didn't think there was somebody behind him, but
yeah.
Mizzouni, got an inadvertent elbow in the kisser from Hunter, who I think is now having a conversation with him. Mizzouni has it blocked. Run out to Wesley Harris. And Harris is fouled as he goes up. So things getting a little ragtag here. The lead up to 30 for West Virginia.
Quentin Shropshire called for the personal.
It was just sort of a slow, methodical victory for the Mountaineers. Came against a pretty good team. When you beat a pretty good team by 30 points, and, it never really felt like we've seen more than our share of blowouts here in some of these early season games. This didn't have the feel for most of this game of a 30-point game.
No, it did not. You're exactly right. Well, this may be the last opportunity for that bench to score. I'm sure West Virginia won't take a shot if indeed they get a rebound or a steal.
go for the crossover, the spin off the glass, and good. And the bench has scored.
Has spoken.
Down to 29 points to lead. And Buda Bolden will dribble things out as the Mountaineers are going to win 91-62. They will improve to 3-1 on the season. Dan Monson, the veteran coach, and Bob Huggins, another veteran coach, shaking hands, and they will be enjoying a plane ride down to Orlando tomorrow.
Yes.
Sags Kanate, terrific game for West Virginia. He and Chase Harler earning career highs. Excellent game from West with 22. Kanate winds up with 20 points in this game in just 23 minutes of play. And West Virginia, really an impressive early season victory.
Yes, it was. It really had been tested. American really didn't, you know, put up much of a fight, and certainly Morgan State didn't. This looked to be a much more difficult game, and it was. It was more difficult than the other two.
On behalf of the men's basketball team, thank you.
West Virginia obviously moving on now to the Advocare Invitational down in Orlando, where they will be expected to face some stiff competition.
Please drive safely.
As you mentioned, the game's coming up against Missouri and Pitt, or Virginia and Pitt as well. There's Dan Monson on the left, the Long Beach State coach, as we go over to Robbie and Smikowski with Chase Harler.
Yeah, how about a career-high 14 points for Chase Harler, and a very happy Lamont West coming over to pose for the camera. Chase, how much fun is this with a career-high tonight for you?
You know, it was a great night. We won. My teammates put me in pretty good positions. I was just hitting shots tonight.
How much have you grown with the limited playing time and experience you got last season that you were able to take into this season?
I learned a lot from last season, just watching the guys. Had a great summer. Put a lot of work into my shot, and it kind of paid off tonight.
How about when you look at, you're a sophomore. You're going to grow with this program. How encouraging are nights like tonight, knowing you're going to be the guy that this franchise counts on for the next 3 years?
You know, it means a lot for Hugs to trust me as much as he does. I've grown a lot, and I'm really looking forward to the future.
Congratulations, Chase.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks. Here is Bob Huggins having a couple words with SID Brian Messerly. Bob, when you look at the three sophomores who we talked about at halftime, Harler, West, and Kanate, how encouraging is it to see those guys have nights like tonight?
Well, that's what you recruit them for. I mean, honestly, Chase has worked his butt off. I said in the pregame show with Tony that if he starts making shots, he's really good because he plays so hard. West coming in is a lot to learn. There's a lot to try to understand, but he's done a heck of a job.
How about the process in integrating them into your system when you have such a younger team than you did this time a year ago? How do you help these guys move forward and play the way you want them to?
Practice. And it's all repetition. It's all, you know, it's muscle memory, so we got to just keep doing it over and over again. Kind of like what you do. Stand in front of the mirror, comb your hair, talk in your brush, you know?
It's a beautiful head of hair.
Yeah, it is.
Let's get this back on track here for a second. Sags Kanate, how much has he grown, and how much is he able to just kind of take his game up to another level?
Well, he can get a lot better. He shot the ball really well today and scored in the post today, but, you know, he slowed down. He didn't force things. It's repetition. I mean, if you don't do it and just keep doing it and keep working with them, then they're not going to get any better. We do a lot of repetition. Have you heard repetition?
Yes.
Okay.
Kind of like this, me and you. It's a lot of fun. I enjoy this. You do too, right?
It's always a blast with you.
Thanks, Bob. All right, Robin Warren.
Guys, thank you very much. Always interesting to see what's going to come out of that interview. And always interesting to see what's going to come out of West Virginia. So many different players. Kanate tonight, 20 points, 7 rebounds, 4 blocks, 22-8 for West. He had a career high, did Kanate, as did Chase Harler with his 14 points. And the Mountaineers go on to defeat Long Beach State 91-62 to improve to 3-1 on the season. For Warren Baker, Robbie and Smikowski, our entire AT&T SportsNet crew, I'm Rob King. Thanks for watching West Virginia Basketball on AT&T SportsNet.